KMBC 9's Michael Mahoney is live at police headquarters right now where they just announced the arrest. Michael, how much did police tell us about what led to Jackson's arrest?
Very little, Larry, very little at all. In fact, they concentrated this news conference on announcing charges against the Waldo rapist of 1983 and 1984. Coincidentally, they happen to be the person of interest that they are holding in the Waldo rape case of 2009 and 2010. Jackson was taken into custody on parole violations about 25 hours ago on the east side of Kansas City, and cold cases from those times in the mid-1980s, the winter of 83 and 84, are the charges that he faces now. These are from the Waldo area. No question about that. Is the fact one of them from East 78th Street down on Waldo area, 69th and Oak, 82nd and Walnut, and East 81st Street. There are 15 counts all, including robbery, rape, and assault. In the late afternoon news conference, the police chief, Jim Corwin, very loosely, however, tied the rape cases from the winter of 83-84 to the Waldo rape cases of today. Here is what he said.
While Jackson is considered a person of interest in the Waldo rapes, additional investigation is necessary before he can be charged with those crimes. Detectives are still following leads in the case and analyzing the evidence.
And a lot of that analyzation on this is taking place with the most modern techniques available, specifically DNA evidence and other tools of investigation that were not available 25 years ago. That's a quarter of a century. The lead investigator on the Waldo rape cases of 2009 and 2010 spoke about the technological advances that produced the charges that were announced today. Here's what he said.
We were aware that we had a pattern back then, and they didn't have the DNA technology that we currently have today, and our cold case unit, sex crimes cold case, was able to work up those cases using the arrangement that we have with the Jackson County Prosecutor's Office and our crime lab. We've developed a protocol that's yielded some very good results.
Back live here at police headquarters. So the headline today is that a person of interest from the Waldo rapes of 2009 and 2010, a man by the name of Bernard Jackson, has been charged with four different rape incidents in the winter of 1983 and 84, a total of 15 counts, including rape, including sodomy. That's the latest from here. Back to you.
Michael Mahoney, thank you very much.